Hi friends, in today's session we will start with a fresh chapter, chapter number 5, States of Matter. This chapter comprises with theory as well as numerical. So in this session we will start with the first introduction or synopsis of this chapter, and then gradually we will increase the 111 topic of chapter. So synopsis of this chapter, सबसे पहले title crack करते हैं States of Matter. In chapter number 1, we start our first theory, what actually means by matter. So, matter is anything that occupies space and has definite mass is known as matter. So, the title is States of Matter. Matter is subdivided basically into three parts, solid, liquid and gas. In this chapter, we have to discuss in detail gaseous state. Standard 12, chapter number 1 is solid state. Standard 12, chapter number 2 is all about your liquid state, means solution. And in this chapter also, we have 2 to 3 properties of liquid state. Major part, all about gaseous state. So, in synopsis, first we have to discuss once again what actually means by matter, that is called introduction to this chapter. Then first part, various types of intermolecular forces. There are three types, dispersion force, or you can say that London force, dipole-dipole force and dipole-induced dipole force. Then immediately we introduce what actually means by gaseous state. So, gas ke liye kuch discussion karenge, do ya teen topic, definition deke gaseous state kya hai, and kuch characteristics of gas padenge, and then immediately we move on to the most important part, heart of this chapter is Boyle's law, Charles law, Gay-Lussac's law, Avogadro law. These are the four pillars of this chapter. On the basis of this, we have to derive one equation that is known as ideal gas equation. That is PV is equal to nRT. Next important topic of this chapter is known as Dalton's law of partial pressure. Kinetic molecular theory of gases. Deviation from this ideal gas behavior. Liquid fication of gases, means gas is converted into liquid also, jo LPG cylinder aapke ghar pe aata hai, that is liquefied petroleum gas, how gases are liquefied, to wo liquefication of gases yahan pe dekhenge. Then liquid state, introduction denge liquid state kya hai and kuch uski characteristics ho ya fir property bolo aap, vapor pressure kya hai, surface tension kya hai and viscosity kya hai, uske liye discussion karenge. And last pe hum discussion karenge chapter ke numericals. So this is all about the synopsis of this chapter. So without wasting much time, in this session we'll start with the introduction followed by the various intermolecular forces. First point, introduction to this chapter, that is states of matter. Sabse pehle matter define karenge fir se. Solid kya hai, liquid kya hai and gas kya hai. This we already discussed in chapter number 1. To bahut jyada time na lete hue, ek quick brush up kar lete hai what actually means by states of matter. Matter is anything that occupies space and has a definite mass. Matter mainly exists in a three different states like solid, liquid and gas. Then we will introduce the definition of each state, that is called a solid. Solid has definite shape and definite volume. This is because in solid the particles are closely packed and so the intermolecular force of attraction is greater. Liquids have no definite shape but have definite volume. In liquid, the intermolecular force of attraction is smaller than that of solid. So, the particles do not have fixed position. Gases have no definite shape and volume. Here, the particles are far apart from each other and hence they have no force of attraction. So, basically, it's a simple definitions of solid, liquid and gas. So let's start with the first topic of syllabus, intermolecular forces. Intermolecular forces are the forces of attraction and the repulsion between the interacting particles. Attractive intermolecular forces are known as van der Waals force. These forces are include dispersion force or London force, dipole-dipole force and dipole-induced dipole force. A particularly strong type of dipole interaction is hydrogen bonding. In chapter 4, last topic we already did, that is called hydrogen bonding. So in this session, we have to discuss three major types of attractive forces, like dispersion force or London force, dipole force, and last, dipole induced dipole force. So much wasting. Without wasting much time, let's start with the first part, that is dispersion force or London force. Atom and non-polar molecule are electrically symmetrical and have no dipole moment. सबसे पहले dipole moment chapter number 4 याद कीजिए. A molecule having partially positive charge, partially negatively charged, have some dipole. Best example HF, hydrogen partially positive, fluorine is partially negative. And due to this, there is some dipole moment present in it, and that bond is known as polar bond. But in an atom, at a particular moment, the nucleus is shift towards to one side and the electrons to the another side. So temporary dipole is created. Means basically what happened at a particular moment, nucleus shift to this another side and electron shift to this another side. Basically ये बहुत कम बार देखने को मिलता है. ऐसा कभी नहीं होगा कि nucleus एक तरफ चला जाएगा, electron एक तरफ चला जाएगा. But this is a physical force, this is not a permanent force. This results in a development of this instantaneous dipole on the adjacent atom for a very short time. Most important, this is for a fraction of second or fraction of moment. This temporary dipoles of atom attract each other, and this force of attraction between a temporary dipole is termed as London force or dispersion force. This force are important only for short distances, for a short time. This cannot be measurable quantity. This is a physical force of attraction. After completion of London force or dispersion force, two important part, that is called is dipole-dipole force and dipole-induced dipole force. Dipole-dipole force act between the molecule possessing a permanent dipole. Once again, permanent dipole किसके साथ होगा? The molecule have partially positive and partially negative charge. Best example मैंने quote किया हुआ है HCl and HF. Hydrogen having partially positive, chlorine have partially negatively charged, that is called as permanent dipole. This molecule interact with the neighboring molecule. This interaction is strong than the London force, but is weaker than ion-ion interactions. Because only partial charge are involved, the attractive force decreases with the increases of the distance between dipoles, as for example HCl. देखिए ये एक HCl इन दूसरा HCl. Here in case HNCl, this is HNCl. इन दोनों के बीच में Cl is partially negative, H is partially positive. Here in case you have a dipole-dipole force, but this is only and only feasible when they are very close to each other. If distance increases, attractive forces decreases. Means बहुत ज़्यादा distance हो जाए तो obviously इन दोनों के बीच में attraction नहीं रहेगा. And due to this, we have a very weak dipole-dipole force. This is only and only feasible when the molecules are very close to each other. Third one is dipole induced dipole. Ab name itself suggests dipole induced. Induced means next molecule ko induce karna dipole moment ke liye. To here in case ek molecule hoga jiske andar permanent dipole moment hoga aur dusra atom ya fir molecule hoga jiske andar dipole moment nahi hoga, jisko hum prerit karenge attraction के लिए, that is called dipole induced dipole force. So आप figure में से ही आप assume कर सकते हो H2O लिया है, hydrogen and oxygen के बीच में बहुत ही अच्छा dipole होगा, और उसके बाजू में है xenon. Xenon is almost noble gas. Noble gas है तो इसके अंदर कोई dipole moment नहीं होगा. And due to this, there is some kind of induced. Oxygen is more electron negative, तो वो xenon को थोड़ा सा induce करेगा attraction के लिए. दूसरा एग्जाम्पल यहाँ पे बताया है ICL. Fine, तो here in case xenon, तो chlorine is more electron negative, तो ये attract करेगा xenon के particle और electron को, उसकी तरफ खींचेगा. That is dipole induced dipole moment. Discussion start करते हैं. This type of attractive force operates between the polar molecule. and the non-polar molecules. Permanent dipole of this polar molecule, induced dipole on the electrically neutral, most important, जो नेक्स्ट स्पीशीज है वो इलेक्ट्रिकली न्यूट्रल होना चाहिए. अगर पॉजिटिव या नेगेटिव होगा तो ऑब्वियसली वो अट्रैक्ट हो ही जाएगा. दिस इज अ न्यूट्रल स्पीशीज, दिस इज इनर्ट गैस, इसीलिए इसके ऊपर ये इफेक्ट आ रहा है, इसलिए डायपोल इंड्यूस्ड डायपोल. वंस अगेन द परमानेंट डायपोल ऑफ दिस पोलर मॉलिक्यूल इंड्यूसेस डायपोल ऑन द इलेक्ट्रिकली न्यूट्रल मॉलिक्यूल बाय डिफॉर्मिंग इट्स इलेक्ट्रॉनिक क्लाउड. इलेक्ट्रॉनिक क्लाउड का मतलब क्या होगा, इसके आउटरमोस्ट शेल के अंदर जो इलेक्ट्रॉन है उसको वो अट्रैक्ट करेगा. दस एन इंड्यूस्ड डायपोल इज डेवलप्ड इन द अनदर मॉलिक्यूल एंड द अट्रैक्शन बिटवीन दिस मॉलिक्यूल इज टर्म्ड एज डायपोल इंड्यूस्ड डायपोल फोर्स. सो हियर इन केस इन दिस सेशन विल डिस्कस अबाउट टू टाइप्स ऑफ फोर्स. वन इज डायपोल डायपोल फोर्स एंड अनदर इज डायपोल induced dipole force. So ये आपका first session था, introduction to this states of matter and then followed by your various kinds of intermolecular forces. In this part we have to discuss three sub part, that is Lenden force, dipole force and dipole induced dipole force. So this is all about your today's session. Next session will start with introduction to this gaseous state and the varieties of different kinds of law. This is all about your today's session. Thank you.